Chapter 37. It happened when King Hezekiah heard it, that he tore his clothes, and covered himself with sackcloth, and went into the house of the Lord. He sent Eliakim, who was over the household, and Shebna the scribe, and the elders of the priests covered with sackcloth, to Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amoz. They said to him, "Thus says Hezekiah, this day is a day of trouble, and of rebuke, and of rejection. For the children have come to the birth, and there is no strength to bring forth. It may be that the Lord your God will hear the words of Rabshakeh, whom the king of Assyria his master sent to defy the living God, and will rebuke the words which the Lord your God has heard. Therefore lift up your prayer for the remnant that is left." So the servants of King Hezekiah came to Isaiah. Isaiah said to them, "Thus shall you tell your master, thus says the Lord, don't be afraid of the words that you have heard, with which the servants of the king of Assyria have blasphemed me. Behold, I will put a spirit in him, and he shall hear news, and shall return to his own land, and I will cause him to fall by the sword in his own land." So Rabshakeh returned, and found the king of Assyria warring against Libnah, for he had heard that he had departed from Lachish. He heard say concerning Tirhaka, the king of Ethiopia, "He has come out to fight against you." When he heard it, he sent messengers to Hezekiah, saying, "Thus shall you speak to Hezekiah, king of Judah, saying, don't let your God in whom you trust deceive you, saying, Jerusalem shall not be given into the hand of the king of Assyria. Behold, you have heard what the kings of Assyria have done to all lands, by destroying them utterly, and shall you be delivered? Have the gods of the nations delivered them, which my fathers have destroyed, Gozan, and Haran, and Reseph, and the children of Eden who are in Telassar? Where is the king of Hamath, and the king of Arpad, and the king of the city of Sepharvaim, of Hena and Iva?" Hezekiah received the letter from the hand of the messengers and read it. And Hezekiah went up to the house of the Lord, and spread it before the Lord. Hezekiah prayed to the Lord, saying, "O Lord of hosts, the God of Israel who sits above the cherubim, you are the God, even you alone, of all the kingdoms of the earth, and you have made heaven and earth. Turn your ear, O Lord, and hear. Open your eyes, Lord, and behold, and hear all the words of Sennacherib, who has sent to defy the living God. Of a truth, Lord, the kings of Assyria have laid waste all the countries and their land, and have cast their gods into the fire, for they were no gods, but the work of men's hands, wood and stone, therefore they have destroyed them. Now therefore, O Lord our God, save us from his hand, that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that you are the Lord, even you only." Then Isaiah the son of Amoz sent to Hezekiah, saying, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, whereas you have prayed to me against Sennacherib, king of Assyria, this is the word which the Lord has spoken concerning him. The virgin daughter of Zion has despised you and ridiculed you. The daughter of Jerusalem has shaken her head at you. Whom have you defied and blasphemed? And against whom have you exalted your voice and lifted up your eyes on high? Even against the Holy One of Israel. By your servants have you defied the Lord, and have said, with the multitude of my chariots I am come up to the height of the mountains, to the innermost parts of Lebanon, and I will cut down the tall cedars of it, and the choice fir trees of it, and I will enter into its farthest height, the forest of its fruitful field. I have dug and drunk water, and with the sole of my feet will I dry up all the rivers of Egypt. Have you not heard how I have done it long ago, and formed it of ancient times? Now have I brought it to pass, that it should be yours to lay waste fortified cities into ruinous heaps. Therefore their inhabitants were of small power. They were dismayed and confounded. They were as the grass of the field and as the green herb, as the grass on the housetops, and as a field of grain before it is grown up. But I know your sitting down and your going out, and your coming in, and your raging against me. Because of your raging against me, and because your arrogance has come up into my ears, therefore will I put my hook into your nose, and my bridle in your lips, and I will turn you back by the way which you came. This shall be the sign to you. You shall eat this year that which grows of itself, and in the second year that which springs of the same, and in the third year sow and reap and plant vineyards and eat the fruit of it. The remnant that is escaped of the house of Judah shall again take root downward and bear fruit upward. For out of Jerusalem shall go forth a remnant, and out of Mount Zion those who shall escape. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Therefore thus says the Lord concerning the king of Assyria. He shall not come to this city, nor shoot an arrow there, neither shall he come before it with shield, nor cast up a mound against it. By the way that he came, by the same shall he return, and he shall not come to this city, says the Lord. For I will defend this city to save it for my own sake, and for my servant David's sake. The angel of the Lord went forth, and struck in the camp of the Assyrians 185,000. And when the men arose early in the morning, behold, these were all dead bodies. So Sennacherib, king of Assyria, departed, and went and returned and lived at Nineveh. It happened, as he was worshipping in the house of Nisroch his god, that Adrammelech and Sharezer his son struck him with the sword, and they escaped into the land of Ararat. Esarhaddon his son reigned in his place.